Good morning and welcome. And it's lovely to welcome Brother Paul and our dear sister Sue to morning prayer. And to those who've not logged in, you are welcome. Though it is a dark, wet, chilly morning here in Cumbria, and according to Brother Paul, they've had a beautiful sunny day. How wonderful. But never mind, Brother Sun will come sooner, hopefully rather than later. But it's good to welcome you to our morning prayer, to that special time when we gather around this table of love, God's love, and where we give thanks for our abundance, for our blessings, and even for the trials that beset us. For in every situation, God's love always triumphs and gives us the strength to shoulder whatever burdens we embrace. So we begin by lighting a candle, and we offer today, especially for the tragic loss of life in North America, I think it was Michigan, I'm not sure, Kalamazoo, where many have been killed innocently. So we pray for the souls of those who have been taken from loved ones, and we pray for the perpetrators of these crimes. But we remember the whole family of God, all faiths and none. So we light this light in the name of our Father, Mother, God, who creates life, in the name of Jesus, the cosmic Christ, who loves life, in the name of the Spirit, who is the fire of life, in the name of Gaia, our Earth Mother, and Mother Mary, our Heavenly Mother, for both nurture the divine life in all lives. And we welcome all faiths and none to this table. Though we have different names for God, we are still one and the same family, members of the mystical body of God. So let us be still now, and just be mindful that we are in the presence of God. And we take a deep breath, and now we say the prologue for the Sunday morning communions. We enter the eternal and infinite garden with reverence to the heavenly Father, Mother, God, the earthly mother, and all the great masters, and reverence to the holy, pure, and saving teaching, and reverence to the brotherhood and sisterhood of the elect. That's you and me and all those who have surrendered their heart to divine love. Sunday morning we commune with the angel of earth, saying, angel of earth, enter my generative organs and regenerate my whole body. And as you say this, you contemplate the life-generating soil and the growing grass, feeling the currents of the angel of earth transforming his sexual energies into regenerative forces. Amen. And now for the office of Lords for the second Sunday of Lent. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And now for our special hymn for Lent. God of thy pity, unto us thy children, bend down thy ear in thine own loving kindness, and all thy people's prayers and vows ascending, hear, we beseech thee. Look down in mercy from thy seat of glory, pour on our souls the radiance of thy presence. Drive from our weary hearts the shades of darkness, lightening our footsteps. Free us from sin by might of thy great loving. Cleanse thou the sordid loose, the fettered spirit. Spare every sinner, raise with thine own right hand all who are fallen. Glory to God, the Father, Mother, everlasting. Glory forever to the soul begotten, with whom thy Holy Spirit through the ages reigneth co-equal. And our first antiphon this morning reads, Truly your decrees are to be trusted. They are more wondrous than the surgings of the sea. Our first reading is Psalm 92, and the theme of the psalm reads, The splendor of the Lord Creator. The Lord is King, with majesty enrobed. The Lord has robed himself with might. He has girded himself with power. The world you made firm, not to be moved. Your throne has stood firm from of old. From all eternity, O Lord, you are. The waters have lifted up, O Lord. The waters have lifted up their voice. The waters have lifted up their thunder. Greater than the roar of mighty waters, more glorious than the surgings of the sea, the Lord is glorious on high. Truly your decrees are to be trusted. Holiness is fitting to your house, O Lord, until the end of time. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Truly your decrees are to be trusted. They are more wondrous than the surgings of the sea. And the second antiphon, springs of water, bless the Lord, give glory and eternal praise to him. And our next reading is a canticle reading from the prophet Daniel. And the theme of the canticle reads, Let every creature praise the Lord. O all you works of the Lord, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you angels of the Lord, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you the heavens of the Lord, O bless the Lord. And you clouds of the sky, O bless the Lord. And you all armies of the Lord, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you sun and moon, O bless the Lord. And you stars of the heavens, O bless the Lord. And you showers and rain, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you all you breezes and winds, O bless the Lord. And you fire and heat, O bless the Lord. And you cold and heat, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you showers and dew, O bless the Lord. And you frosts and cold, O bless the Lord. And you frost and snow, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you night time and day, O bless the Lord. And you darkness and light, and you darkness and light, O bless the Lord. And you lightnings and clouds, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. O let the earth bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you mountains and hills, O bless the Lord. And you all plants of the earth, O bless the Lord. And you fountains and springs, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you rivers and seas, O bless the Lord. And you creatures of the sea, O bless the Lord. And you every bird in the sky, O bless the Lord. And you wild beasts and tame, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you children of men, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. O Israel, bless the Lord, O bless the Lord. And you priests of the Lord, O bless the Lord. And you servants of the Lord, O bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise forever. And you spirits and souls of the just, O bless the Lord. and you holy and humble of heart. O bless the Lord. Ananias, Azaris, Mizelo, bless the Lord. To him be highest glory and praise for ever. Let us praise the Father, Mother, the Son, and Holy Spirit. To you be highest glory and praise for ever. May you be blessed, O Lord, in the heavens. To you be highest glory and praise for ever. And we omit the Gloria and we go on to the antiphon. Springs of water, bless the Lord, give glory and eternal praise to him. The third antiphon, all kings and peoples of the earth, praise God. And now our final reading is Psalm 148, and the theme of the psalm reads, Hymn of Praise to the Lord, the Creator. Praise the Lord from the heavens, praise him in the heights, praise him, all his angels, praise him, all his hosts. Praise him, sun and moon, praise him, shining stars. Praise him, highest heavens, and the waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord. He commanded, they were made. He fixed them forever, gave a law that shall not pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, sea creatures and oceans. Fire and hail, snow and mist, stormy winds that obey his word. All mountains and hills, all fruit trees and cedars, beasts wild and tame, reptiles and birds on the wing, all earth's kings and peoples, earth's princes and rulers, young men with maidens, old men together with children. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he alone is exalted. The splendor of his name reaches beyond heaven and earth. He exalts the strength of his people. He is the praise of all his saints, of the sons of Israel, of the people to whom he comes close. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. All kings and peoples of the earth, praise the Lord. And now we come to our special reading for the second Sunday morning of Lent. And it's from the prophet Nehemiah. This day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep, for this day is holy to our Lord. And do not be grieved, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the short responsory, Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on us. Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on us. You were wounded because of our sin. Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on us. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God. Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on us. And our Benedictus antiphon for the second Sunday of Lent reads, Jesus Christ our Lord brought an end to death. He has proclaimed life and immortality through his gospel. And now I'd like to invite you to join me for the Canticle of Zechariah, the Benedictus. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has visited his people and he has redeemed them. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour in the house of David his servant, as he promised through our prophets from of old, a Saviour who would free us from our sin, from the hands of all our enemies. So his love for our Father is revealed and his holy covenant remembered. He swore to Abraham our father to grant us that free from fear and safe from the hands of our enemies, that we might serve him in holiness and justice all the days of our life in his presence. And as for you, little child, you shall become a prophet of God the Most High. You shall go before the Lord to prepare his ways before him, to make known to his people their salvation through forgiveness of their sin and the loving kindness of the heart of our God, who visits us like the dawn from on high. He will give light to those who sit in darkness and those who dwell in the shadow of death. He will guide them into the way of peace. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Jesus Christ, our Lord, brought an end to death. He has proclaimed life and immortality through his gospel. And now we come to our morning intercessions. Let us glorify God for his wealth of goodness and pray to him through Jesus Christ, who is always living to intercede for us. And the response, inflame our hearts with your love. And we repeat, inflame our hearts with your love. God of mercy, help us to enrich this day with deeds of kindness. Let men know by our actions that we are all one family. Response, inflame our hearts with your love. At the time of the flood, you saved Noah through the ark. Grant salvation through water to those preparing for baptism. Response, inflame our hearts with your love. May we never live by bread alone. Give us life by every word you speak. Response, inflame our hearts with your love. Help us to avoid all anger and dissension. Let us find joy in your peace and love. Response, inflame our hearts with your love. And now for a moment or two, let us be still in the presence of God. And let us bring to our Father, Mother, God, those whom we wish to remember this morning, the situations that we may be in that's causing us trouble or disquiet, or maybe we're concerned about what's going on in the world. Let us be still. Let us bless and release everything to God. And now we pray with Brother Paul for Carol Ann as she prepared for her up and coming divorce. We also pray for her partner and all the families involved. We remember today those who've joined us for prayer, for Sister Sue and her family, for Brother Paul and his family, especially his aunt, and his good friends Joey and Sean. We remember all those who've asked our prayer today, too many names to mention in our request book. But we bring every one of them to our Father, Mother, God, thanking God for touching their hearts today. And I want to pray for our two beloved sisters in Philadelphia, Sister Eleanor and Elizabeth, whom we Skyped for the first time we were able to Skype in 12 months because of Sister's illness. And we had a joyous Skype for an hour, well, 90 minutes. And it was so wonderful to be able to see how God is touching both of them, which has been a pretty horrendous journey. So we give thanks to God for dear Eleanor and Elizabeth and for their faith, their courage, and for their gift of presence in our community. We remember all our brothers and sisters of the Teo community, past and present. We pray today for Brother Bjorn and his community, and we thank him for inviting us into their community as a sister organization, and we are truly grateful for that, as we are also grateful to be a sister group within the Order of Franciscan Hermits, whom we remember this morning in our daily prayer, all the members, especially Brother Mark and of course Brother Paul. We pray today for the massacre that's occurred in America, in North America, I believe it's Michigan. We pray for the sadness, and we pray for the gun lobby in America. We know that it funds a number of senators in their political career, but we pray for integrity, and we pray for the sacrality of human life, which is worth more than any gun. We pray with Brother Paul for Greg's father who has lung cancer, and we pray for all the prayer requests in the Order of Franciscan Hermits Facebook group. We pray today for those struggling with the Zika virus, and I believe a male has contracted the virus, which is just amazing. So we pray for him. We pray for those involved on the front line who are caring for those and their little children, their babies. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, who made a wise decision to encourage the women in Brazil and the affected areas to consider using contraception to stop them getting the virus. And I thank God for this wisdom. We pray also for His Holiness the Dalai Lama. And we pray for every man and woman who have dedicated their lives to God, to Yahweh, to Allah, in service for unity and peace. We pray for all our Franciscan brothers and sisters, both in the Christian and non-Christian traditions. We pray for unity and peace and togetherness within our Franciscan family. And finally, we give thanks to God for this free channel, that we are able to connect, to break bread together in love, and to celebrate our gift of faith together. So let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, Mother God, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give to each one of us today, and to Brother Paul and Sister Sue and those not logged in who are here with us, our daily bread. Forgive us our disobedience, for the times when we panic, for the times when we become insecure, for the times when we have offended in charity, be it thought, word, or deed. Protect us from the forces of evil, negativity, and despair. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And our closing prayer, the second Sunday of Lent, reads, God, our Father, Mother, you bid us listen to your Son, the Well-Beloved. Nourish our hearts on your word, purify the eyes of our mind, and fill us with joy at the vision of your glory. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus the Christ, who lives and who reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And that, my dear friends, brings us to the end of Sunday morning prayer, the Office of Lords, and for our final blessing, the blessing of heaven, the blessing of earth, the blessing of sea and sky on those we love this day, and on every human family, the gift of heaven, the gift of earth, the gift of sea and sky, the gifts of brother sun and sister moon, and the gifts of the animal kingdom be in your heart, this day, this night, forevermore. Amen. As I blow out this flame representing the cosmic Christ, I ask the Lord Christ to touch each one of you and all whom we have prayed for today. Amen. So namaste, shalom, inshallah pax et bonum, om shanti, solo di caritas, salam alaikum, and may the peace of our God enrich your life and reawaken your heart to the I Am presence of God within. Amen. I wish you all a blessed day, and I wish our dear brother Paul a pleasant, restful sleep. God bless you, and thank you for being here. We praise you, Lord. Lord, in our excellencies, and in our hearts, Lord.